One of the most common form of data that exists today is tabular data or structured data. In order to get answers from tabular data, you either use pandas or you use SQL-like languages. What if I tell you that Google has recently open-sourced one of their models wherein you can ask questions about your data in natural language? So this is what it is called. In India, it is called as Tapas. In other countries, you may pronounce it differently. But this is essentially based on the BERT model. And in this video, I'll kind of go over the repository so that you can play around with the repository and understand the structure better. And in the next part of the video, I'll walk you through a live question answer system that you can generate on your own CSV file. So without wasting any further time, let's get started. So this is the repository structure. It has a sample notebook as well. They have also open sourced a pre-trained model. So big shout out to all the contributors who have kind of open sourced this amazing piece of work. And it would be really advantageous for all of us to utilize this amazing work and make cutting edge predictions on our tabular data. So all the steps are clearly mentioned. If you want to retrain this entire algorithm on a different data set altogether, if you want to fine tune the algorithm basis your data set, then there are steps mentioned for that as well. So essentially, it's a very good piece of work that has been open sourced, and I would highly encourage all of you to go through the research paper as well. And also, if you like the content of the repository, feel free to star it as well as fork it. And I'm sure this will find a way in a lot of applications which require tabular data. Now that I've walked you through the entire repository structure as well, let me jump directly into the notebook execution piece. This notebook is the official version of the notebook that exists in the repository that I just showed you. However, I've slightly modified this so that you can make use of the custom Excel file that you have and make predictions on the questions that you feel are relevant to you. So let me show you the directory structure before I start installing the necessary modules. So I've already uploaded the file data.csv. Don't worry about the file availability. It would be present in the description section of the video. So I'll upload the custom version of the notebook in my repository. I'll link everything in the video description section. So having said all of this, let's move forward and go for the actual implementation of this amazing library. The first thing that you'll have to do is you'll have to clone the repository. So let me run this cell. Remember one thing, I've already selected the type to be GPU because I want to make predictions on a tabular data set. So that is where I've already selected the runtime type to be GPU. So now that the repository is cloned, let's move forward and install it in the instance that we've just created. So let me run the cell. So all the installation is complete. It tells me to restart the runtime in order to use the newly installed version. So I'll go ahead with that as well. So I'll click on runtime. I'll click on restart runtime and I'll press yes. So the runtime has been restarted. Let's move forward and fetch the actual pre-trained models from Google storage. So let me run this cell. Now that the pre-trained model has been downloaded, let's move forward and import the necessary modules that are required. Now that the necessary modules are up and running and I've also downloaded the model for making a prediction, let's load the latest checkpoint from the model. Now there is a slight modification that I mentioned earlier that I've made to the default notebook. That is, I've included my own data set. And I want to retrain it partially so that I can make predictions or I can ask questions about my own Excel sheet. So let me run this cell. One other thing that I want to specify is before you pass in the input values in order to retrain the model for your custom data set, it requires all your columns to be string values and not integer or float values. So let me run this cell in order to convert all the columns to a string type column. So the data set that I've chosen is a very simple data set that contains the top 10 run scorers in one day international cricket. So as you can see, Sachin Tendulkar kind of leads the pack. We have Kumar Sangakkara, Ricky Ponting, Sanat Jayasurya, Virat Kohli, Saurabh Ganguly and Rahul Dravid in this amazing list of cricketers that are there. So now I want to ask questions about this tabular data using the amazing library that Google has open sourced. So if I have to repeat, what I've done so far is I've imported the Excel or the CSV file that I had. I've converted all the columns into string type. And the next thing that I'll have to do is I'll have to convert the data frame into a list of lists. But the only catch there is I will also need the first element of that list of list. That is, the first list should be the column names that are there. So that is what I've tried to achieve here. Let me show you the output in a cell above that. So all of this will kind of make sense. So this is how the input should be to your pre-trained model. So as you can clearly see, the first element or the first list inside the list of list contains the column names. The first row is basically the first element and not the zeroth element, and so on and so forth. So once this structure is ready, the next thing that I'll have to do is I'll have to make predictions. And the other change that I've done is whatever input that you get or whatever input that you see in the default notebook, I've kind of modified it to actually have a list of lists already inputted. So that is what I've modified here. And yeah, that is all that was required. So let me run this cell. Now that all the effort has gone behind creating the setup for the final stage, let's actually move on to the final stage of the output. So the input to the predict function is basically the list of lists that I just created. The first question that I'm asking to this amazing tabular data that I've just captured is, what were the player names? The next question that I'm asking is, of these, which team did Sachin Tendulkar play for? The third question that I'm asking is, what is his highest score? And the fourth question that I would require an answer for is, how many runs has Virat Kohli scored? So let me run this cell and show you the power of this amazing library. So here you have it. You have the data frame displayed in front of you. So it essentially gives out the output of the first 10 rows that you have. The first question that I asked was, what were the player names? So it gives me all the player names in this column that was there. So essentially this answer is again correct. The next question that I asked this amazing pre-trained model was, of these, which team did Sachin Tendulkar play for? And as you can clearly see, it gives the right answer, that is India. So let's verify that. So for Sachin Tendulkar, so it was very accurate in predicting the team for that particular player. Since it also remembers context, the next question that I asked to this model was, what is his highest score? I didn't specify Sachin Tendulkar. I just specified what is his highest score, and it was smart enough to tell me that the highest score for Sachin is 200. And suddenly I changed context from Sachin to Virat, and I went forward and asked the question, how many runs has Virat Kohli scored? And it gave me the accurate answer of 11,867. This data has been collected till March 2020. So don't blame me if you see the video in 2021 or 2022 when the table has changed. So yeah, that is all that I had in terms of this demo. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I truly wish that you incorporate this in your workflow to answer questions about your tabular data. If you do like the content that I post on my channel, it would be really motivating if you can press the subscribe button. And also press the bell icon to be notified for future amazing data science and machine learning videos. Thank you so much for watching the video.